A Pixel can be a great phone to shoot vlogs and reels and TikToks, but here's my Pixel 7 Pro shooting video from the front-facing camera sensor. You just sort of hold the phone and you look at this sensor and you line up your shot in the viewfinder and you're shooting a vlog. There you have it, folks. Super easy. You know, drop me a comment down below and smash that bell icon. We're gonna dig in a little bit more than that. It doesn't take a whole lot to spruce up the video quality a little bit more. In a handy run-and-gun situation, I think this looks pretty good. But if we really want our talking-to-camera videos to pop a bit more, one simple addition. Now I've moved from holding on to the phone to using a little mini tripod. Specifically, I'm using a Joby GorillaPod, but really, anything that you can kind of pick up and easily carry. The thing I like about little mini tripods is that you can also use these very quickly to set your phone down. But this one little addition of stability kind of helps me frame the shot a little bit better, gives me a little extra reach if I kind of want to play with distance and framing from the camera. And a setup like this should be pretty cheap. There are plenty of vlogger and mobile content creator kits that are going to give you all the little pieces and parts, but really we just want two things. We want a tripod, again, so that we can hold on to the phone and that we can set it down. And then we need just some kind of little phone mount. This right here I got from Ulanzi. The really cool thing about a Pixel is this is a phone that manufacturers of accessories are starting to take more seriously. So we can get a little fancier and step up to a nicer accessory system. What I'm using on my Pixel 7 Pro right now is the Peak Design case with a magnetic attachment. That alone, one of the nice perks we can point to using a Pixel. From here, if we want to get really fancy, we can step up to something like a motorized gimbal to really smooth out some of the additional arm and hand movements that, you know, are always going to be a part of cell phone video when we're out on the go. For myself personally, I kind of like keeping this a little simpler. I think it's a little easier to set the phone down. Not all gimbals are going to come with additional tripods for better stability if you want to set your phone down. And then if we start mixing in other accessories, things like audio devices, I kind of like having the static platform to work in better audio or lighting. I think this looks pretty good for selfie camera video footage. I think Pixels do this reasonably well. But if we want our phone video to stand out just a little bit more, well, there are better cameras on the phone to shoot with. Hey, and look at this. Now our video has a slightly different texture to it. It has a slightly different look to it. It's got a shallower depth of field. It's got better dynamic range. And the cool thing about a Pixel is that we've got this little strip of cameras where I can very easily line up my face in the reflection on the back of the phone and see kind of where I'm shooting. I can kind of frame and position this pretty well. Also, on a lot of our phones, we'll probably benefit from slightly better image stabilization on the rear cameras than we will on the front-facing cameras. I totally feel some of you folks, you don't want to take the time to practice and get good at using those rear cameras, but often we also have the ultra-wide cameras. This is going to give us an even better ability. If you're worried about framing, we can shoot wider, then maybe crop in if we need to, or just enjoy more of the scene around us. Like, if you're trying to do this as like travel footage, going from a shot that's more head and shoulders to a shot that really shows off the location, that's such a handy feature to have on these rear cameras. Pretty breezy day right now. I'm getting lots of wind. You can see the trees, the leaves are rustling, and wind is obviously hitting this phone here. And I think the Pixel 7 is doing a very good job of prioritizing my speech and kind of pulling that above some of this ambient nature sound. The microphones on our phones are really good these days. All the noise canceling that goes into, you know, taking a call is also contributing to shooting better talking footage on these cameras. But once we start pushing these little phone microphones a little bit harder, we can hear how that effect might start to fall apart.
For just a quick, casual, pull your phone out of your pocket, shoot a little video situation, the microphones in our phones are great. Here's the funny thing about Pixels. They do not have a bunch of those features and settings and controls that we usually take for granted on more professional systems, the types of cameras that we use for a lot of production and vlogging. But they're surprisingly good, if you dig into a few of the menus on a Pixel, at supporting things like Bluetooth audio. You have a decent pair of earbuds, you can connect it to the phone, and the phone is going to record that audio. A bunch of phones do this well, but if you drop down to 30 frames per second on a Pixel 6 or a Pixel 7, what you can do is also enable an enhanced speech filtering mode. It's some surprisingly clean audio, considering I'm just going over a little pair of Bluetooth earbuds.
Now, this is the worst case scenario on a windy day, standing right next to a freeway, and I don't really feel like yelling to get my audio out. This is where we can go with something really fancy. Here I'm using a dedicated microphone. This is a transmitter. These little wireless mics have been rocking my socks lately for really improving our audio capabilities out in the field. And it's a really easy way. They can get a little pricey, but it's a really easy way to also add two microphones to one receiver. Plus, your audio is on your subject, so I've got a closer proximity to this mic than all the noise around me. You'll hear me way better than if I were using some kind of like little mini clip-on boom microphone from the phone. That would be the phone's perspective for the audio, not your subject's perspective for the audio.
It really is a windy day today. I'm just trying to find a little bit of shade, just kind of take a break from walking around. But one of the things that I think is also always critical to bring up in these conversations, using our phone for more production-grade kinds of footage. Our phones are communications gadgets, they're gaming devices, and they're also cameras. And I find if you try to do all of those things all at the same time, you end up with the worst absolute experience. This runs true for basically every phone out there, but it's something we've got to pay sort of a specific attention to on Pixels, the way that the Tensor manages thermals and the way that Samsung's radios manage thermals. If you know you're going to be out in the field, you know you're going to be shooting heavy on your camera, don't be afraid to kick into airplane mode for those sequences that you're going to be shooting. Take some of the load off of the phone. It also has the secondary perk of being a little less distracting, especially if you're looking through the viewfinder, not shooting rear camera like I am here. You'll have fewer pop-ups and notifications trying to distract you from composing your frame and shooting your video. Now, I'm sounding like a broken record here, but one of the ideas I refuse to let go of, one of the major advantages of shooting vlogs from a phone, as opposed to, say, like a standalone camera, is the immediacy of being able to look at the footage and then jump directly into editing that footage. You always have to do some kind of file transfer, either through a memory card or you can go over Wi-Fi if you shoot on another camera and then get it into another computer. Here, the phone is the camera and the computer. And one of the benefits of the Pixel specifically is the Pixel 7 Pro currently stands, if you use an app like LumaFusion, as the fastest rendering solution for 4K video. Doesn't matter what those silly synthetic benchmarks say. iPhone 14 Pro, a Galaxy Note 23, nuh-uh, you want to edit and render a 4K video timeline, the fastest completion to task, coming from the Pixel 7 Pro. In conclusion, going back to just the selfie camera and handhold, we can start with something like this, which I think looks pretty good. But with a couple simple upgrades, we can end up with a video that looks like this. And I think this is a really good look for production out in the field. I've moved almost exclusively to shooting from phones, even when I'm doing professional things and covering trade shows. It doesn't take a lot to really step up that video quality. And I'm sure folks in my audience have some other tips and tricks that they might want to share. Please don't be shy, drop some comments down below. All the support lately has been absolutely fantastic. If you're clicking on links in descriptions, if you're catching my home site, somegadgetguide.com, or if you're joining the list of names scrolling by on your screen, from my Patreon. That's patreon.com/somegadgetguy. This list here is basically the coolest collection of tech pals in the universe. So I hope you'll check them out. Now, you know where you can find me around the rest of the internet. I host my podcast on Twitch. I'm spending a lot more time on the Mastodons. I'm trying to revive a Flickr account because it's really genuinely better for sharing photos, a little less so these days on the Twitters and the Facebooks and the Instagrams. And I will catch you all on the next video.